Good morning. Now I will discuss the topic preparation for bath. There are four types of preparation: prepare personal, preparation in the delivery room, test the function of equipment, and test the function of bag and mask. At first, prepare the personal. Bath attendant identifies a helper and explains role. According to the facility available, choose a helper to assist you in neonatal resuscitation. Helper may be a qualified nursing staff, another untrained hospital staff, or relative of mother. Explain the role to be played by helper before labor. Helper is needed to help you to activate emergency plan. You should assign and explain the role to helper according to his or her skill. Helper confirms understanding of roles. Bath attendant describes the emergency plan. According to the resources available at your facility, make arrangements for any emergency during neonatal resuscitation. Make arrangements for calling doctor or another skilled person in resuscitation in case of emergency, or make arrangement for shifting the baby to nearest referral unit. In this preparation, the personnel, there is also washing hands. Wash hands for 2 minutes following 6 steps of hand washing. Preparation in the delivery room. Preparation should include having warm place to do the resuscitation and equipment and supplies. These are summarized here, that a draft-free warm room with temperature greater or equal to 25 degrees centigrade. A clean, dry and warm delivery surface, a radiant warmer or overhead lamp with 200 watt bulb if available. 2 clean, warm towels or clothes. A folded piece of clothes, 1/2 to 1 inch thick. A newborn size self-inflating bag. Infant mask in 2 sizes, size 1 for neonatal, for normal weight baby, and 0 for small baby. A suction device, oxygen if available, a clock with seconds hand. Important points about equipment used for resuscitation. Equipment must be cleaned and checked after each delivery and checked again before the next delivery to ensure it is ready for use. Broken equipment is dangerous and should be replaced. Equipment must be of the appropriate size. Pediatric and adult bag and mask cannot be used on newborn babies who have small and fragile lungs. A volume of the bag should not be more than 250 to 500 ml and generate a pressure of at least 35 cm of water. If a mucus extractor is used, the trap should be big enough, 20 ml at least, to prevent aspirated fluid going into the respirator's mouth. A mucus extractor with a bulb is not recommended because they are difficult to clean and might act as a source of cross infection. Suction should not exceed a negative pressure of 100 mmHg or 130 cm of water. Test the function of equipments. Before bath, check that all equipment and supplies are available and are in working condition. For warm environment, you have to switch on radiant warmer or overheat lamp at least half hour before anticipated time of delivery. Close the windows and switch off fan to prevent drafts of air. Test the function of the bag and mask for ventilation. Fit mask onto the bag and deliver test breaths against the palm of the hand. You should feel pressure in the palm. When the bag is squeezed. Form a seal between the mask and the palm of the hand. Squeeze the bag enough for the pop-off pressure released valve to open and make a sound as the air escapes as in the picture. Check that the bag reinflates quickly when you release after squeezing the bag. Thank you.